Hey everyone, this is Zach with 8020 Automotive, here today with a video on fault code P0040, symptoms, causes, and diagnostics. So on an engine, DTC P0040 indicates that the O2 sensor signals are swapped between bank 1 sensor 1 and bank 2 sensor 1. So ultimately, it's a relatively straightforward fault code and one that indicates that essentially the ECU is detecting that the signals between the oxygen sensors are swapped. Now, this is a relatively rare fault code to receive on an engine, and that's especially true if your vehicle wasn't recently worked on. If your vehicle was recently worked on, this can be a little bit more common if there was just a simple mix-up and an accidental misconnection of the O2 sensors. Again, swapping those wires back and forth is really something that's common or can be common after working on a car if you just didn't pay attention or didn't mark the O2 sensors when they were reinstalled. So anyway, it's a relatively uncommon fault code, again, unless your vehicle was recently worked on and there was a mistake made in reconnecting the O2 sensors or O2 sensor wiring. That said, jumping right into some of the most common causes of fault code P0040, number one is the O2 sensors or the O2 sensor wiring simply being swapped. Another common cause is damaged or shorted O2 sensor wiring. And then lastly, a couple things that are both very rare but could be potential causes of P0040 include issues with the ECU or your engine's computer directly, or potentially issues with the oxygen sensors. Although again, these are both pretty rare. ECU failures don't happen very often, but when they do, it can trigger a number of various fault codes. So usually you'd have more than just P0040 associated with an ECU or computer failure. And as for the O2 sensors, again, with this fault code, it's the ECU picking up on the fact that the signals are swapped between the two sensors. So this would be very unlikely with an O2 sensor failure for the vehicle and the engine to actually believe that the signals are swapped instead of just picking up on the failure. So ultimately, this is very rare because it would most likely require both O2 sensors failing or starting to short out at the same time, and the ECU thinking that maybe with those shorted signals and getting some various readings that they are swapped instead of both just failing. So again, those last two are very rare, and as I kind of mentioned right at the intro in this video, this fault code is almost always associated with your vehicle recently being worked on, and especially something that requires disconnecting or replacing the O2 sensors and simply replacing them backwards and putting them in the wrong banks. So moving that bank 1 sensor to bank 2 and the bank 2 sensor to the bank 1 position, that's going to be the most common cause of this fault code. But before diving into more diagnostics, let's go ahead and jump in and discuss a few of the most common symptoms associated with DTC P0040. So when the O2 sensors are swapped or the vehicle believes they're swapped, the ECU isn't going to have proper information for smooth, efficient operation of the engine, which ultimately means you can end up with a number of drivability issues. Number one, you'll likely have the check engine light. Again, that's going to be triggered with the fault code as it's stored in the car's computer. And then some other common symptoms are rough idle, poor performance, and poor fuel economy. I know poor performance is pretty general, but it really just depends on the exact degree and the specific vehicle as to how bad those symptoms may be. But again, the point remains, if the ECU is not getting proper information or proper readings for the oxygen sensors, it's not going to know how to properly balance your air-fuel ratios, which can lead to a number of drivability issues and symptoms. Last but not least, moving on to our final topic when it comes to actually diagnosing and fixing fault code P0040. The first starting point here is starting with the basics and using your judgment and knowledge based on whether or not the vehicle has recently been worked on. If yes, the vehicle was recently serviced or you recently worked on it, the best starting point is going to be just pulling a diagram of your vehicle's O2 sensors and O2 wiring, and following that, ensuring that all connections are in the proper places. Probably just a small mistake and got the sensors or the wiring mixed up and connected in the wrong locations. So that's going to be your best bet. Just understand where those wires go and what they should be plugged into, and go ahead and potentially fix the issue or take it back to the shop if it was a shop that recently worked worked on the vehicle and potentially mixed it up, they should take that back in, be able to swap them out for you pretty quickly and get everything resolved. If the vehicle wasn't recently worked on, it's very unlikely that any actual connections are physically swapped. And instead, this would be more indicative of potentially any kind of shorted wiring, any damaged wiring, again, potential failure with the O2 sensor or sensors. And so at this point, really the best starting point is just starting with the basics again. Make sure everything is connected. Make sure there aren't any loose wires, loose connections, or that somehow something didn't get missed. You know, if your car was repaired a few weeks before, maybe it just took a while or you haven't driven much and that fault code finally just appeared. Work your way back and then ultimately test the O2 sensor wiring, as well as the O2 sensors themselves. If there are any issues there, it is possible that this is triggered by an ECU failure or issues within that computer directly. So a couple things to keep in mind, but ultimately 99% of the time, if you're receiving this fault code, it's likely just going to boil down to your car recently being serviced and those connections accidentally being swapped. Anyway, guys, that wraps up our video for today. If you appreciated the content, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more in the future. Thanks, everyone.